Can I... Oh! What on earth? A well on point of damage? What happened? I didn't think you'd really do it. Did I cut off a finger? Hello, we're back. We are doing our first 20 minutes of a game, and this week it's going to be Inscryption. I'm super excited about this game. I've heard just enough to get me excited about it, honestly. I've really tried to avoid spoilers as much as I can. And I'm just excited for a spooky vibe. So, what I'm going to do, pause for just a sec. And I've started my 20-minute clock. So before we begin, Inscryption's a 2021 horror deck-building game that just came out this year. It's been on everybody's, or a lot of people's top games of the year, so I really wanted to check it out for a while. It's developed by Daniel Mullins Games and published by Devolver Digital. So I guess we're just going to get started. So we're going to do a new game, which I'm assuming we're already in a new game, so... What are our options here? Continue options. I just want to see what we have here, just in case there's any accessibility stuff that we should be turning on. Dialogue, text speed. I usually crank that up just so it's a little faster for me and for everybody else. We'll keep flicker effects on and screen shake, but if that becomes a little too much, we can always turn that off. Noise effect will keep on. Brightness. I'll crank that up a little bit because YouTube likes to make things dark. I'm just going to crank that down a little bit. Pause the window. Focus. So these are things that I'm going to like probably point out as annoying things. I really wish that this was clear. I'm assuming this means it's going to pause when the window's not focused, but I wish like this label would update to be like, yes, I changed it to this thing. It definitely seems like it'll continue if you keep that on, so we'll keep it, I think, paused. But man, oh man, make things super explicit. That's all I ask. Credits, good. Okay, so technically I did not start a new game. I literally booted it up and then closed it again so we could start this. So it is truly a new game that we're starting here. Got spooky eyes already. I'm very excited. Another challenger. It's been ages. Perhaps you've forgotten how this game is played. I mean, I don't know how it's played. Allow me to remind you. Yes, please. Oh, man. All right, play the squirrel card. Bow. These are situations where I really like, what happens if I don't play it, though? What if I click a stoat? You're lacking sacrifices from the stoat. What did I say? Can't play that presently, but okay. So squirrel's free. So I think the blood... drips are they need sacrifices. So I haven't played too many deck building games. I guess I've played some tabletop games for sure, and then I've played Magic the Gathering, so I'm assuming the blood drips are kind of like your mana in this case. All right, now play your stoat. Your stoat, sorry. All right, so we have to kill. Yeah, so squirrel we're kind of eating up with. That becomes our mana, so we can play our stoat. An honorable death. Play the stoat. Lead. Okay. So let's go back. Wolves require two sacrifices. Oh, I should really... Hold on a sec. Sorry. Text speed's a little too fast if I'm going to read it out for you guys. Yeah, let's try that. That's fine. Do-do-do. These are interesting. I don't know about the slots. Really. And then do I just click out? Okay, cool. Again, I really wish there was like explicit like X to close kind of dealies. Alright, ring the bell to end your turn and commence combat. Okay, so we don't have enough sacrifices for wolves. Ring that bell. Your stoat stands unopposed. The number on the bottom of the left is the attack power. Okay, so attack, health, got it. So that's pretty standard. We smack them for one. Oh, I like the little scales here. Your stoat dealt 1 damage. I added to the scale. Okay. You win if you tip my side all the way down. Like that. Like this. Alright. My turn. Ooh, those eyes. Coyote. Your stoat stands in the way of my coyote. My coyote dealt 2 damage to your stoat. Alright, so I have 1 health left. That means your stoat hits. Yep, health is +2. If a creature's health reaches 0, it dies. Alright. It's your turn again. Those swirly eyes are very good. Okay, you may draw from your deck, or you may play draw a squirrel. Oh, there's just a squirrel deck you can pull from. Interesting. I'm going to pull a squirrel because I feel like those are good to have on hand. How dull. Look, mister. I want to bring those wolves out. Alright, so we get the squirrel. So I think I can back up. Okay, it's going to let me... Yeah, let's play a wolf. Why not? We'll sacrifice both of these and put those in front of the coyote. Fear not, the beast is sacrificed, but not removed from your deck. Its suffering was real. Oh, but you'll see it again. I hope so. Bye, squirrel. Put you wolf down, because you're good. So you got 3 attack. Okay, that's all I can do, so I'm going to ring the bell. Because you're learning, I will pass. Again, the choice. A random card from your deck or the certainty of a squirrel. I'll get the random card. Why not? River Snapper. You're lacking sacrifices. Yeah. And I cannot sacrifice enough for the wolf. So I'll end my turn. Yeah, smack him for 2. 3 damage dealt. 3 weights on the scale. And he's passing. Why? Alright, so I'll put my squirrel down. And then, okay, scroll down to see. So the River Snapper is basically like my little tank. He's got a lot of health, but not a lot of attack. How much? He doesn't have a lot left. I can just end it. Yeah, let's do that. And smack him. What was the dice? Alright, you won this match. They won't all be so easy. Alright. Let me recall your story. Oh, yes. Ooh. You were lost deep in the forest. A single path revealed itself. It sure did. Alright, so I gotta go here. Oh, I like my little token. 2 denizens of the forest approach you tentatively. Ooh, where to? Go right. It's a cat. You're not very attacky. Oh, I can flip over both. Interesting. Okay. Caustic adder damage from its poison bite is always lethal. Oh, shoot. I was gonna see what. I noticed a little infinite dagger thing, but I didn't read what it said. That's okay. Another creature joins your caravan. So we took the cat. That's okay. I was gonna kind of go with the cat anyways. We'll get other dealies that will beat things up and poison stuff, I'm sure. So, some of the creatures of the forest seemed willing to follow you. Came across an abandoned sack. Oh, you found a squirrel in a bottle. Break in case of emergency. And have a second. Okay. Another useful implement. I'll allow you to tip the scales with it. 3 is as much as you can carry. Okay, so it's kind of teaching me stuff. Can't use that right now. Okay, so I gotta keep just chugging forward. I mean, the skull is a little foreboding. Oh, so just gonna drop some stuff. Okay, so you were ambushed while crossing some rough terrain. So there's a boulder. Oh, I'm sorry, Stoat. It was the right place. Okay, I get it. Well, he understands. Maybe you'll help me? Yeah. I can help. Play along for now. Interesting. Okay. So you may now see my moves ahead of time. Okay, so he played a wolf cub. Okay, I can right click on stuff and see. So a card bearing the sigil will grow into a more powerful form after 1 turn on the board. Uh-oh. Oh, cub becomes big wolf. Okay. Interesting. So we have a boulder, a stomp. So I wonder if I have to break through those. As many lives when a card bearing the sigil of sacrifice does not perish. Oh, okay. So that's what the little infinite deal is. Okay. I need to remind you. Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I can break you guys, huh? Can I? Oh! What on earth? A well on point of damage? What happened? I didn't think you'd really do it. Did I cut off a finger? What? I was hoping I could pick those up to like smash the bottles. What is happening? Oh, jeez. I don't really know what. What did I cut off? What does this book say? Okay. Oh boy. All right. Yep. Let's put some squirrels out, I guess, because we're going to have to put... I'm assuming we can put out however much we want. Yeah, let's sacrifice... the squirrel, put the stoat down because he wanted to go out. So here we go. And okay, do I put the cat out? You know what, let's be bold, let's get rid of these guys, put the river snapper out. That's all I can do. So ring the bell. Okay, so yeah, we do have to break through the stumps. Mind the ambitious wolf cub. It ages swiftly. Yes, we know that it will become a big guy. Let's pull a rando. So we get a wolf. That needs two. Cat needs one. But I don't want to get rid of my stoat. I think I'm just gonna keep smacking those stumps. Alright, so we get a full-on wolf now. So the airborne bat flies over creatures who attack directly. Okay, so... got some flying guys going on. Take a squirrel because we're gonna need some meat shields in here. Let's put. Because the cat has one attack. You have two, so you're gonna kill my cat, huh? But the wolf needs two. Oh, I should have thought of this. Well, the bat can fly over anyways, right? So, why not? Let's put the cat out. See what you can do. Okay, and my turn. Alright, so stumps are gone, boulder is gone. So yeah, bat's gonna fly right over the cat, which is not good news. Maybe because I'm worried about the wolf now. He can get through that gap. The bat's just going to keep flying and hitting me. So I kind of have to kill it soon. Do I... basically wondering if I should take a squirrel, sacrifice the cat and the squirrel, and put the wolf out. What are you? You have two health. But three attacks. So you could attack that bat. Hopefully, I don't know if it's going to be a flying thing where, like, I can't hit the bat. Let's see. That'll at least help us learn. Okay. We'll sacrifice these two. Oh, the cat's not going to... dang. Forgot. The cat stays. Alright, well, it's wolf against wolf, at least. Blunder turn. I got rid of the wolf. Bat's gonna hit me again. Oh no. let's see what we have here. Another wolf. You need two sacrifices. I don't want to sacrifice my stoat again because I want him to leave. What if I did something crazy like this? Sacrifice those two. Oh no. Well, oh well. I keep trying to think I'm gonna hit the bat. That's okay. See what happens. Because that's four damage. That at least tip things my way slightly. Pick up a squirrel. Put you down. And then we'll just keep smacking them. Yeah, we're slowly bleeding him, but that's okay. Got a space in the room for that card. Yeah, I can't do anything with these cards, right? I wish I could scoot him around. Alright. And that's it. Okay, you prevailed and trekked onwards past the now blooded terrain. So let's keep on chugging along. Alright, I like this so far. I don't know if this is one or the other, ideally. It's a young wolf cub, so we know that deal. And a sparrow. Ooh, I like the flying ones, so I'm gonna take a sparrow. That's always a good advantage. Okay, let's see what the symbol is. Okay. Just a sacrificial stone, I'm assuming? You stumbled into some strange stones in the mist. You were compelled to choose a worthy sacrifice, one that will be lost forever. Assume I click here. Oh no, I mean, I don't want to get rid of my sparrow, I just got him. The cat feels like it's just blocking a space, so I'm sorry, little kitty. You looked upon your menagerie and selected a healthy host. I mean, the stone is saying pick me. You know what, fine. You've been trustworthy so far, why not? What an honor. Oh, so he took a ghastly spectacle, but the soul of the cat now lives in the stoat. Oh, so I could have made like a flying stoat. Well, had I known. It's alright. Sparrow will still be good. Oh, hello. Behold my totem. It inscribes my canine cards with the airborne sigil. Well, that's kind of a bummer. He's completely insane. You see that, right? No care for the rules. Pathetic, really. Enough. Alright, so he can hear my stoat. Oh, no. Just doesn't want to watch you suffer, buddy. Alright, we'll put squirrel down. And then, the bat's gonna come this way, huh? And the coyote's also flying. It's bad news. They're both 2-1 though, so their health isn't that much. So let's put the stoat out. We're gonna sacrifice the squirrel. Put you here. Although, why'd I do that? Oh no, it's fine. He's just got one health. I was gonna say, our stoat isn't very strong. It's okay. Can I? I don't think I can pick up. Yeah. First turn. Okay. So my totem is granted my... Yeah. It's flying coyote. Great. Not good. Alright. I mean, we're gonna have to take a squirrel because we gotta sacrifice some boys here. And then... Yeah. Sacrifice you. Put the sparrow here. That's our turn. Good. Okay, so ground dealies can at least still hit flying guys, which is very good news. Put the squirrel out. Let's put you here for now, just in case. I don't want to sacrifice anything yet, so... alright. And then... Oh no, is that it? No! Oh shoot! I didn't think I was that close. Yeah. Alright, so using this as a learning opportunity may be the only way to mitigate my disappointment. Listen. Get up. Get up from the table. Uh-oh. Fetch me the candlestick from the top of the barrel beside the door. Okay, so yeah, these are things that I kind of knew about where we're going to be leaving the card table and doing kind of escape roomy things, which is very interesting. So... Okay, so I have to move around. Set the candlestick on the table. Hello. I probably shouldn't have touched that. Ooh. Mm-hmm. Can I take you? No. Interesting. All right, back up a little bit. Okay. So bring it here. Do I have to? Oh, I don't like that hand. Okay, let's sit back down. Okay. Let me explain something to you. That was one of two mistakes you can make here. If you make another, I must sacrifice you. Now, where were we? I mean, that's not very nice. I guess we'll just keep trekking through. Oh no. Alright, so we have the Adder, the Raven, the Conniving Raven, a Blight in the Skies, and the Sparrow. I mean, the Raven. It's expensive with two, but pretty good with 2, 3, and flying, so we'll take him. Okay, so now we're the Raven's choices. So there's a little fire. I should have been paying attention to what these symbols were. Oh, that's a sacrificial stone. I don't necessarily want to, like, imbue anybody else yet, so let's see what the fire is. Oh my goodness, and I think we're already at 20 minutes, so let's wrap this up and then I'll take a break, but so far I'm really enjoying this. So you came across a small group of survivors, faces shrunken from starvation, they huddled around a campfire. And they looked upon your group of creatures and beckoned. Come warm one of your creatures by the fire, one said. Warm it by the fire, that will enhance its power, said another. You notice that one of the survivors wiping drool from their mouth. Oh no, they're gonna eat them. No. So we have to, I mean, I have two. Oh no, no, no. I can't feed you my stoat. My Raven and Sparrow are pretty sweet. I think I'm gonna sacrifice one of my wolves. We get two of them, right? Yeah, I guess eat up. Okay. So they did enhance it, they didn't eat him. The fire warmed the poor wolf, enhancing its power. One of the survivors reached toward it. Another gnashed their teeth. Without a word, you pulled the wolf away from the fire and left. Okay. Interesting. Okay. I really like this. So I know it was short, but this is a good little peek into Inscryption. So if you've enjoyed this, please let me know, because I'm totally happy to play more. This is just the first like kind of 20 minutes peek just to get our feet wet. Leave a comment letting me know if you want me to play more. Like, share, and subscribe. Do all the things if you enjoyed this. And I will catch you guys in the next first 20 minutes. See y'all.